Alright, what's going on, guys? I've been drafting every single set that comes out. I don't know if you guys have noticed. We don't have a quick draft, which is disappointing. Because the player drafts are so expensive. But here's the cool thing, right? Oh, these are... No, I don't... Nope. Nope. No. Those are bad rewards. Holy crap. That was the wrong one. Think we want to go here? This looks a little bit better. So here's the thing, right? The Mastery Pass is 3,400 gems. And I have 3,000. I only need 400 and then it's free, right? Kind of free. I mean, technically I could draft with these gems. But like, if I get 400 gems, then I get to... And I just get all the stuff for free. So what do I need to get for 400 gems? I need... Oh, that's a big jump. So I need to go 3-3. So I need to go perfectly even. And I get two attempts. I'm not going to do both attempts. But we need two attempts. And I could just wait for quick draft. That'd be a better value. But I'm pretty sure I'm going to get the mastery pass for free. So let's just go. Unfortunately, this is a player draft. Player drafts are... They're 10,000 gold, which is a lot. So like it's hard, they're harder to break even in a real, I mean, obviously if you can get into these, the value is pretty insane if you're good enough to get up in here. The rewards are much better at the high end, but it's much, much worse at the low end. And it's 10,000 per try, so it's expensive. I'd rather just do best of one quick drafts, but whatever. Let's just go. I have not drafted, not only have I not drafted this at all, but I haven't really played that much. I mean, you might have seen in the main screen, I haven't done my dailies and stuff. We are player drafting though, so this, ooh, Solemn Sim, that's kind of cool. Oh, this is pretty good too, actually. We didn't get a really good, like super crazy bomb rare here, which is too bad. So it's really just a matter of, do we want to try this whole dog thing, which is pretty good actually. Or do we just take this because it's decent? Like it's not mind blowing, but it's pretty good, right? Get a land, draw a card. Is it really worth first picking though? I've heard this is really good. I think we're taking this though. Are we? Is it really that good? I guess it's fine. It's not exciting, but it also, we're not committed to a color, so that's nice. I'm probably going to slow this draft down just because I have to read everything. So we have good removal, kind of good removal, 5 mana removal. So looking at this pack, we do have a massive flyer. So that's pretty cool. This also seems decent. It's going to get big. I think this might actually be the best card in the pack, potentially. This could be good too. I just don't know if it's a good draft. I'm leaning towards just getting the big giant flyer just as a finisher. Or obviously that's the removal spell. I feel like a 6-6 flyer has to be insane in this format, right? It's a core set. It's got to be good. I think I just go with the big stupid flyer. I think it's fine. Ooh, we have really good removal. We have really good removal. These keep being passed and I heard they're really good. Someone told me these are really, really good. I don't know if... Oh, we got Hop 2. Essence Capture. I think we just go. We go with this, right? Eliminate. We have to go with Eliminate. We're in Rakdos. I think we're in Rakdos. I'm like 90%. Duress is okay. This is decent. 2 mana 2-2 deals damage every turn. Blow up a creature is pretty good. This is fine, but not great. I'm leaning towards blow up a creature, actually. But it's 5 mana to blow up a creature. And this is decent. It's a nice... we'll blow up a creature. We're going to blow up creatures. It's fine. We've got a land. Nothing else. Ooh, we're not getting hit. We're getting a lot... White and blue seems really open. I think we just take the land, honestly. I mean, Sure Strike is good. Maybe Sure Strike is fine. Yeah, Sure Strike's a fine combat trick. And now the problem with player draft is we have to wait. At least there's no, like, one single person who's slowing the whole thing down. So that's nice. With all these... I just noticed all these nickel boluses. Kind of funny. That was on sale. Not recently, but a while back. That's the only reason I have it. I don't really pay that much for cosmetics, but every once in a while you'll see an avatar in the store for like 500 gold or something. And then it's like, all right, fine. I'll buy the nickel bolus avatar for 500 gold or whatever I paid for it. I don't remember, but it was low enough that I deemed it worth the money. All right, well, I said there's not one person holding us up. And now there is. Man, lots of green too. I picked the same color that I think these people on my side are picking. I've heard Turtle Ogre is also pretty good. This seems decent. There's lots of small creatures in this format, right? If we control a creature, 4 power deals 2 damage to each opponent. I mean, it does have reach. Reach could be useful. So do we want a 4-3 that deals 2 damage, or do we want a 3-3 that deals 1 damage to any target? Oh, it's any target. But it does have reach. It has one less power. This is a tough choice. It's between these two, I'm pretty sure. I think one damage to a creature seems better than just hitting the opponent. And the reach is nice, but we have removal. So I'm going to the archer. Alright, let's see. This is bad. This is expensive. 3 mana, 2/3. Pay 2, tap each opponent, loses 2 life. That could be... Oh, only... Becomes blocked by a creature. That creature's... Oh, it's so expensive. It's so expensive. I think we just go with this. It's not exciting, but it's fine. Let's see. We've got Rise again. Could be okay. We've got 6 mana, 4/5. Menace. Not really liking that. Enters the battlefield. Tap. Not good. I think we just take the reanimation spell. We have some big targets. None of this looks great. But sure. Am I going to play that? Maybe. 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 Curse probably fine. Flash? So again, we have two very similar cards. I don't think we're playing this. Well, Death Touch is okay, but we're playing one of these, and they're very fundamentally, like, similar. 2 mana, 1/2. 2 mana, 2/1. This one has Flash, but it's more expensive. I think I'm gonna go with this one, although the Flash does seem kind of nice. This is all terrible. I'll just take the land. Duress is fine. Land is great in our colors. That's pretty good. So nothing too crazy here, but this is a core set. And again, I haven't drafted it, but you know, we have some good removal. That's nice. Cage Zombie, who knows? Maybe that's decent. Seems kind of bad. I did read a guide. I don't need more ops in my collection. I don't know if I have Tranquil Coves because I never play blue-white. Yeah, sure. I have heard that the creatures are very small. I read like a... Oh my god, it's in our... Oh, it's artifacts. Can we get enough artifacts to make this worth it? 3 mana, 4 or 5/4 flying is amazing. It can't attack. It can still block. And we create a treasure token for each... No, I've never read this card, apparently. It activates itself. Well, then we do take that, right? Is there any reason why we wouldn't? It'll eventually... animate itself with the treasure tokens. I've never read that. I've only read the beginning. I didn't realize it produces treasure tokens. Well, sure. That seems decent. So we have dragons. That's cool. So we're kind of looking for artifacts. We don't necessarily need them, but we're kind of looking for artifacts. Sort of. Double vision would be pretty cool if we had more spells. I mean, we have some. I don't think it's worth it, though. Not really what I'm looking for, so I'm thinking it's probably either this or this. I think this is better. 4 mana, 3/4 is fine. We could sacrifice the creature if we want. Otherwise, it's just a pretty solid body. I think it's reasonable. This scythe, I've played it in, like, the events, you know, the... Wait, what's this do? X damage seems pretty good. That I don't want. Shock. Oh, no. This has been insanely good in the, like, the, not the FNM events, but the, like, the artisan events or whatever they're called. You know, those random events. I think this is actually really good. I think we keep this. Right? This also seems pretty good. But I think it's, this is pretty insane. Scorching Dragonfire is amazing. That's probably, we do have an artifact. But I think Scorching Dragonfire is definitely what we want. Removal is good. We'll take the removal. Our curve isn't looking terrible. My last draft, when I drafted Akoria, my curve was horrendous because I picked every big creature ever. This is looking a little bit better. I haven't even really been looking at other colors. I realized that just now. I committed to black-red and just haven't been paying attention. But we're getting a lot of it from this direction, so that's good. I guess we just take removal. I mean, is this really worth it? And we could always do that in response to removal spells, but I don't think it's as good as just blowing up whatever. So we'll go with that. We have another one of these. It seems decent. Seems okay. I don't like this. It's too expensive. This isn't that exciting. I think being able to just ping stuff seems reasonable. Ooh, Deathblow Valid. That's pretty cool. To be able to combat, you may have target. It's 4 mana. Flip a coin. No. So it's this, this or this. I don't think a 4-2 is good. I don't think a 3-4 is that great. I think this is pretty decent. Pretty good value. Two creatures on one card. See, we have another one of the big... it's too expensive. I can't. It's so expensive. I should take this. But it's a big giant dragon, guys. Why would we want a big giant dragon? I want a big giant dragon. Oh, we have more removal. That's pretty good. Double the power of target creature to return them. That'd be good with our dragons. That'd be pretty good with our dragons. And it's instant. Actually, instant? Instant makes it more exciting. I still think... our removal's so clunky. But I think we take the removal spell. But that's a game finisher for sure, though, right? Well, it picked for me. Fortunately, I had... Yeah, I was on that. I wasn't paying attention to the timer. I think we take this. Actually, I'm not going to play that. Let's just take the uncommon from my collection. That's fine. Is duress going to be good and limited? I don't know. I'm going to take this, I think. Seems fine. This card... No. This card seems good. I'm not going to play it, but... It seems like a decent card. 4 mana, 4-3 that comes into play tapped. Or a menace creature. I guess we can take this. Really expensive. Really clunky. Both of these are terrible. Sure, but we're not going to play it. We got... Oh my god, all of our rares are on color. It's so great. Well, we just take that, right? There's no way we're taking anything else. There's no way. There's... No, we're taking this. Well, that's pretty nice. When all of your rares are on color, that helps a lot. We have more... These are not being picked, which is kind of scary because I've been taking a lot of them. We have another one of those. None of this seems great. Man, 5 mana removal is so expensive, but I guess it works. Our mana curve has gone downhill. Oh, I didn't look at this. 3 mana, 3/3 at the beginning of our combat. Sacrifice another creature. If we do, it gets +2/+2. Engage trample. Not great. Are we really going to take that? Oh, we have this too. Sacrifice creature, gain life, and draw a card. Huh. That's kind of... I like this, actually. I like it because we can do it in response to things. We can dig for stuff. I think it's decent. Duress? I don't know if duress is good. I think we're just... No, we have enough 2-drops, really. Maybe duress is just fine. Guess duress is fine. Or do we take the big clunky giant thing? I mean, we have too much big stuff. But are we really going to play duress? And I don't think this is great. Well, I'll take this. I have a feeling it's going to get cut, but we'll take it for now. 2 mana, 2/1 flying, give it death touch. So it's kind of a removal spell. I think that's probably fine. Nothing else is really jumping out at me. Yeah. A bad removal spell is what that is. I mean, we have lots of 2-drops, and we're probably going to take another 2-drop here. Another really bad removal spell, but it does work with our... Maybe we take that. It's a 1-drop. It'll give us mana, something to do with our mana late. It's fine. Lifelink is nice. But I think we take this for the sake of our curve. I think that's fine. Look at our curve. It's really bad. Now, we need 3-drops. If we see 3-drops in these last few picks, that's probably what we're going to do. Just to make this a little bit better. We have all the 2-drops ever. We have another 1-drop. I've heard this is really good too, actually. Another one of those. We have too many of those. I'm going to end up cutting those. This seems really good. Insta speed. Oh, wait. No, it's any target. So it's between these two. And I've heard short sword is better than it looks. So I think we're going to take that. Oh, that's okay. We do have a 3-drop, but it's not a good one. I don't think I want to play that. So we're going to take another 2-drop. Take another really bad removal spell. Sure. There's a 3-drop. So I think we just take the 3-drop for curve reasons. This is... Fine. This seems so good. It seems so good. I'm taking the splashy spell. I don't care. It seems fun. We'll have one. It could potentially win us the game or lose us the game if we get it off top with no creatures in play. But whatever. I haven't had to wait that much this draft. That's been nice. No one really holding up the draft. So that's pretty cool. I'll take the duress. That might get cut. That'll probably get cut. Most likely. Man, more of these. That will also probably get cut. None of this is being played, so I'll just take whatever for my collection. Yep. Man, yep. Okay, well, that's a deck. Is it a good deck? I don't know. I'm gonna just do this off camera. Give me a second. Alright, this is our deck. You can look over it if you want, but that's what I'm playing. So let's just get into a game. We'll get into a game. See if we can manage to get 400 gem things. What's the worst that could happen, right? We lose and... Oh, no. Well, that's a bummer. We go first, but no. That's not much better, but at least we have... Okay, Arena's just trolling me, but... We're gonna put that on bottom, because I don't know if it's gonna be good or not. There's no board. There's no board for... And that's kind of disappointing. We're playing on Ikoria board. Kind of boring. It's boring board. It's not a boring board, it's just... Of course. Well, we're just not gonna do anything ever. Three turns and... neither of us has played anything. There we go. Somebody played something. That's good. Alright. My turn. I'm gonna play something. Here we go. Ready? Maybe. There we go. Let's get a swamp. Yes. Swamp. Alright. We have our colors. We can start casting things. That's pretty cool. Gonna take one. Fine. Death Touch. That's fun. Do we just blow that up? Maybe we blow that up. I don't want to deal with that touch. So let's blow that up. And then play this. Play this. If we had that dragon, we've got three artifacts. So that's pretty cool. Attack for a three. Put it good to 17. Okay, so... we're doing... Oh, don't look at it. Don't do it. Yeah, I don't have mana for that. We're doing okay. Opponent was just as slow as us. Maybe this format's just slow. I don't know. All I've heard is that small creatures are... How could you? How could you do that? Well, I'll draw a card. We can get it right back, I guess. Get another land. Sure. What I've heard is that the format is really small creatures and the sword is supposed to be really relevant, but what do I do here? I guess we can do this. We can equip and we will end, and if they try to kill it, we can sacrifice it, draw a card and stuff. Take one, sure. When it dies, it was 3 damage at each target. That card's pretty cool. Why didn't we see any of those? Or did we and I just missed it? 3 damage. That's perfect. So we will... play this. We will... blow that up. Oh yeah, I forgot. So funny thing... I literally just read that and then immediately forgot what it did. Oh, and I should have activated that before it died. Oh, God. Okay, well, I'm good at magic, guys. I swear. This is not going well. I'm not prepared. What did I just do? That was a just absolute disaster of a punt. Can't believe I just did that. I literally read it and thought, hey, that was cool. And then I blew it up and my thing died. And then I didn't activate my thing. I could have killed the flyer. We have to kill that. And we'll pass, and we're going to take 4 damage again. Yeah, I could have killed the flyer, so that's 4 damage I've taken from that I shouldn't have. There's another one, that's scary. There's another one of those. Huh. So let's, wait, are we just dead? We're not dead if we kill this. We're going to take 4 good, too. But I think I just punted my way to a loss there. That was not good. That was absolutely terrible. Yeah. Okay. Sure. Yeah, we lose. Yeah, that was just a disaster. Should have shouldn't have killed the devil right away. I should not have, or I should have killed the flyer. Because if I would have blocked that, the damage would have been negated pretty much. Or it would have went to me, but it would have been as big of a deal. So blowing up the devil thing was kind of dumb. Super dumb. Don't do that. Don't do what I did. Guys, I'm just giving you an example of what you shouldn't do when you draft, which is play like an idiot. By the way, I didn't mention, it's going to be confusing now because I kind of forgot to mention, I'm recording this pretty early. I don't know when I'm going to post it. The Planeswalker decks are coming out. I'm going to be doing upgrade guides on those. So I don't know if this is going to get done and get edited before that's released, before those are going out, or if it's going, this is going to get delayed till after that, which means that you might not see this for like 3 or 4 weeks because I'm going to do upgrade guides on all those and that'll take a while. So yeah, I don't know when this is going up, but I'm recording it literally like 6 days. Here we go, finally. Like 6 days after core set was added to the to Magic Arena. The best of one drafts aren't even out yet, to give context. This isn't a good start, but we're going to try it again. Go try it again. And we're going to get 400 gems, guys. Going to do it. Or I won't, and I'll just wait till best of one drafts come out, which will probably be in a couple of days. I'm guessing it comes out this weekend as I'm recording this. And that'll give me 2 more attempts to get the gems to get the mastery pass. Bolas versus Ugin. Makes sense. This hand is fine. It just doesn't, like, there's no creatures. But like, it's fine. But there's no creatures. But it's fine. This cauldron has been kind of doo-doo. Want to keep it. Hope we draw a land. We just need one. We'll draw one, right? See, there's that card. I've heard it's good. We did draw a land. That's pretty good. So, I guess we just play this. That's fine. We're drawing more lands. Fancy. Well, I have all the artifacts. So that's cool. There's another land. Yep, we have indeed drawn the lands. So that's cool. Play a 2/3. Next turn we can equip. Attack. Sounds cool. Don't play a big creature, please. Please don't play a big creature. No, don't kill my creature. That touch. It's not fair. Well, we will, wait, we could just kill it. Could kill it, attack for 2. I think that's reasonable, actually. Kill it. Attack for 2. Don't get the scythe, which is too bad, but that seems fine. A 2/5? That's so lame. Well, we will equip here. We will play this. Play this. Did we play land? I did not. And we can't attack. We're probably just going to move this right over here, but whatever. A 7/3. Holy crap. That might. Oh, we do have death touch. We do have death touch. So it's fine. So I guess we're not attacking. We're just going to pass. We've drawn a lot of lands. Drawn a lot of lands. A whole lot of them. Too many. I forgot to move this over. Fine. Fine. Lame, but fine. Eliminate. That can't kill that. And now this can't kill that. So that's a bummer. So we're probably just going to chump block. And then flash this in, draw some cards. Or they don't attack. That is nice. So we can make them lose 2, and that's it. I think we still just draw cards. We can draw 1. Let's draw a card. It's another death touch creature. Cool. So, death touch. Let's move this over correctly this time. We'll play this. We will equip here. That's probably fine. And I believe we just pass. This costs 2. 1. It only costs 1. So that's nice. So we'll pay 1. Well, they can't attack, basically. If they attack, we pay 1. What's this do? Draw cards. Sure. And more. I have so much land. I have had a crazy amount of land. Huh. I guess we're stalemated for now. Pass the turn. Maybe. Why is that? I've clicked it like 4 times. What are you doing? We're stalemated for now. I have lots of removal in my deck. I just need to draw something. Can kill that. Can kill that. Sure. We're gonna kill that now just in case they have something big in hand they want to cast. That's fine. My turn. Oh wait, could I activate this? Does it have to be my creature? It's any creature. God dang it. Oh, hey, look at this. Big creature! Ha ha ha. Let's just go ahead and... Oh, nope. I need one for the death touch. So we're not going to do that. Why is this button not working? Look, I'm clicking it. There it goes. It's really weird. I keep clicking it, nothing happens. So Dragon Dude's going to win us the game, I hope. Scry 3, reveal a creature or a land, draw a card. If it's creature or land, draw a card. I see. All of three on top, that's scary. But their top card isn't a creature or a land, so they don't get it. Interesting choice. Okay. Well. Block. There's a combat trick here, I'm guessing. Or they just really wanted to draw a card. Okay. When it enters the battlefield, more draw. What's this? Wait, creatures you control have trample? I don't like that. Don't like that. So this has trample now. Bummer. We have to race him with our dragon dude. Alright, draw. That's pretty good. So we're going to move this over here. We're gonna move this over here. Is it worth playing that or do we just pump? Oh, we can do it. Tap all black lands. Play Thalid. I'm not even going to worry about the death touch at this point. We're racing. Activate. Let's hope they don't have bounce. That would be the worst problem here, is a bounce spell. But we'll pump over mana into that. They're dead next turn. That's pretty good. I can actually still kill this by double blocking. I'll get a token out of this. I'll take a bunch of damage, but I can't survive. If they kill this, what's this doing? Draw 2 cards and discard. Oh, it has flying. God dang it. But why though? But why? So we're not going to win. Unless we draw a removal spell. Does it have like hexproof or anything? It's really obnoxious. We could still attack all out and still win. That's gonna have flying too? God dang it. Okay. They have so many cards. Holy crap. This has gone downhill. All I really need to do is draw a removal spell for this thing, and maybe it's okay. That is not a removal spell, but first strike kind of works. Sure. Attack. Maybe I should have moved the equipment around, actually. That might have been smarter. Oh, they just concede. Okay. Yeah, we had first strike. We could have put it on the dragon when they blocked, and that would have been fine. But it's okay. We win. Nice. But sure. What are we at now? We're at 100. Need to get that 3 wins. That's all we need. I just need 3 wins. We have a nice curve. I mean, we have 2 and 3 drops, so it's not like an exceptionally good curve. We can play this turn 1. This is fine. I have to remember to actually use this. That's another land. Didn't really need that, but it's fine. Gain a life. Opponents in blue-white. 1/3 flying is not too threatening. So, do we just play this? So we don't have to worry about being attacked? Probably. Or no, we can just... They can't attack us with this either, right? Yeah. Because if they attack us for 1, we attack back for 2. There's a chance they'll play a creature and attack, but... I'm not that worried about 1 damage. Yeah, they do. But we can kill that. Oh, they're going to attack us for 3. Seems reasonable. We'll play this. We'll just kill this. We don't have to do it now, but I'm going to do it now anyway because... Oh, it's player Planeswalker. I've been looking at this wrong the entire time. It's fine. Let's just play the bigger creature. I'm good, guys. I don't know why I thought that hit creatures. Well, that makes me feel a little bit better about my punt in the first game. I couldn't have killed the 1-1 either way. Could have dealt one damage to them, but that wasn't too relevant. I mean, I still messed up, but it's not terrible. This thing is a piece of crap. I don't care about it. We're going to block here. We take one. We'll deal one to them. Okay. We've got 4 mana. We can play this to block their Pegasus. And we'll start attacking for 2. Pass the turn. Still have Eliminate up if they play something that's actually threatening. They don't do anything. That's pretty cool. I think we're going to play this. I think I'm going to discard the creature because I don't have mana for it. And that's not great either, but that's fine. That's fine. Whatever. So we can kill that next turn with this. No, we can't. We need a mana. That's fine. I think we kill this no matter what. It's actually getting in my way. I want to start attacking now. So we'll deal a damage to them. Oh, we draw a land. That's good. That's good. So I will play this. I will kill this. And now I can start attacking. They can block the 3. They're going to take 3 per turn, though. Okay, and we have tons of removal. So if we can just kill their stuff that they play while staying offensive, that'd be pretty good. Return stuff. That's fine. Whatever. Alright, they bounce that. I think what we're going to do is we're going to attack. Like so. If they block this, it's going to get death touch. They don't. Okay, so that goes like that. We play this. Deal one here. And we can pass the turn. Alright, that's not bad. We got rid of that wall, which is annoying. They're getting high in mana now. That's pretty good. They're getting a lot of mana. But we have so much removal. Eliminate's been kind of awkward, I gotta say. And these turn to slags are so expensive. My turn. That's pretty good. So, let's attack like this. If they block, they don't. Okay. Do we play another threat or do we just blow up their thing? I say we blow up. Okay. They're at 8. We have 2 removal spells. We have a combat trick, which could be relevant. Could also just kill the opponent if they don't block next turn. Another one. Holy crap. Well, those are obnoxious. Sure. I think we have to rebuild our board for a turn. Yeah, we can play a 4-drop and a 2-drop. So I think we... Huh. What, do we want to discard it? I don't think so. I think we just play this as a 3-4. That's it. No discarding. We'll also play this. That's pretty good with their life total so low. Not going to attack this turn. Next turn, we have Sure Strike. We have Turn to Slag. If we draw a land, we can do both of those, which would be pretty great. Eliminate could be relevant if they play a small creature. They do not. That gains them life, though. That's annoying. So they can attack for 6. And I'm probably not going to block. Oh, jeez. Well. They're in blue-white, so I'm just going to... I'm going to go to 3, which isn't the most fun thing ever. Scorching Dragonfire is pretty good. So... What do we have? We technically have 10 damage, but we're dead on the backswing. Let's attack like so. We need to keep a blocker back. That's reasonable. So we will do this. That's dead. Yeah, I think we're okay so long as they can't do anything with the Fetidim. We can kill one attacker. We can kill the other with that touch. Do they have a counter spell, though? I don't think they have anything, so that's good. Block. Death touch. Pass. Okay. We can kill that with Eliminate. So, Eliminate that. Attack for 5. Play this. Deal a damage. Okay, we have Turn to Slag to kill any creature they play. Oh my god, there we go. Whew, that was a game. That was a game, but we got there. That was not, that was a close game. But we did get there. That was pretty cool. That was a pretty cool game. One more win. One more win gets us into the where we want to be with the thing. With the gems. You know what I'm talking about. This is terrible. This is really terrible. This is absolutely poopy doo-doo. This is fine. It's fine, I guess. It's playable. It's not good. But it's playable. Probably have to put this back. Because I'm never going to have mana for it, probably. We will put the dragon down there. And we'll never see it again. I don't think we have any way to shuffle our deck. So, that is gone forever. Probably. That's another land, though. We really needed one of those. So, that's pretty good. So, we have turn 2 imp. We have, I mean, a turn 3 standard bearer isn't good. But, I mean, we have it. That's a decent card. I guess. We'll play this. So they either have to spend all their mana to deal damage or play something and then just attack for 1, so. That's the problem with that card. That's why I ended up cutting it. It's really good in like the super, super late game. I didn't realize when I was drafting it that it only gets power, doesn't get toughness. So I don't really like it that much. I would prefer that it got toughness. I should have picked the flash thing that got, I think it got +1/+1, right? That seems better. Sure. I forgot they had that, even though it's right there in front of my face. So we do not block. See, now I need eliminate. What's this do? Another creature gets indestructible. Sure. So I guess we just pass, and we planned a sure strike. I think that's the idea. I guess I should have played this. But I can also play this if they have, like, a burn spell. So I think it's fine. Sure. Don't like that all their mana is open, but sure, we're gonna sure strike. What's funny, if they have like, if they spend all their mana to pump their creature, we can give ours death touch, and since it has first strike, okay, they're gonna give it indestructible. So I guess we just let that happen. Yep. So some mana would be nice. These Turn to Slags are as clunky as I imagined they would be. Oh, it's another expensive thing. Maybe we just pass, play this to block. I don't like doing that, but it's a bad removal spell, basically. Sure, if they have a sure strike, then that's gonna be a bummer. Yeah, Turn to Slag seems okay, but it's so expensive. I should probably cut, like, one at least. I think I have 3 in the deck. I think it's too many. It's just awkward. Alright, so that's dead. Doesn't feel great, but it's dead. That's okay. Out of land. I just need one land. Do we just play this? No. We play this. I need 2 lands, technically. At least we can block this and kill it, although they could put the equipment on it, which wouldn't be great. I think that's what they're gonna do. What's it do? Win it and at least 2 other creatures attack, so killing this Igneous Cur thing is probably a good idea. I'm trading bigger creatures for some- oh, they don't just- okay. That works. No blocks. Sure. A flyer. Alright. I don't have lands. Please. They don't. Technically, they don't have lands either. To be fair. But we're drawing all this clunky crap. And I don't have lands. So it's looking like we have to win the next game. Because we're not going to win this one, I don't think. We have to win next game. Or I don't get my gems. Which is a bummer. Sure. At least we can block the 3-2. Does it? Oh. I think we just take this. Sure. Land? No. Eliminate's good. But we lose. We lose because we didn't draw lands. They didn't draw lands either. But we had too much expensive, clunky crap that we couldn't cast. Ugin versus Boloth again. No lands. Please, give me lands. I just want land. There we go. Those are lands. We can keep this. Everything in my hand's good. I mean, I don't have... Here's the thing. If I put, like, this back, for example, and we start drawing land, I'm going to be mega screwed. So even though we drew lots of land, I think we put one back and hope we draw one. We're going to draw one. Because obviously I technically want five. But I think we have a better chance of drawing... That's not one. We have a good chance of drawing one, right? So we can play this, which is, like, all I really want to play. So it's probably fine. It's probably fine. We'll kill that. But that's not a land. Well, this is awkward. This is awkward. I was expecting to draw a land. What's that do? We'll kill that too. We're just gonna kill everything. Gonna kill all the things. Please land. Please, 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 please. Well, at least I can cast it. I can cast it, so it's fine. I'm not gonna complain. Not gonna complain. But god dang it. Why? Two games in a row. I'm gonna get stuck on one less land than I need. There we go. There we go. That's nice. That's nice. Let's attack for three. Does this do anything? I didn't look. No, it's fine. Okay. And I think we just play this just to play. We're not gonna discard. Or we're not gonna sacrifice. Just have a 3-4. Okay, don't kill that. We know that now. Ooh, nice. So we play this. We will equip here. Or do we equip here? I think we equip here. They're gonna kill my thing, because I'm gonna attack. And they're gonna block this, then deal the 3 damage to it and kill it. But that'll put another counter on this thing, and that's pretty good. So I think this is fine. Nope, they just take it. Well, that was unexpected. Sure. So we'll just pass. Maybe they just have removal. Maybe they have a turn to slag. Maybe they have a turn to slag. They're looking at it. No. They're just gonna lock it down. But they attack, so that's interesting. So we're going to move this here. We can do 8 with this thing. Which isn't bad, but we're not going to do it now. We're just going to hit for 4 pass. Opponent's at 10. Just want to win this one game, please. Sure. Sure. Tempered Veteran. Put +1/+1 counters on things. Fair enough. Man, if I had drawn a land, I could have played this. That would have been nice, wouldn't it? But, did not. Did not draw a land. So we'll play this. Scorching Dragonfire. Well, that's a pain in the butt. Oh, we don't get the token. God dang it, really? Really? Because it got exiled. So many things exile now. It's like, what's the point of having death triggers? Like, everything exiles. Fine. Fine. Give me a land, please. Sure. Give me a land, please. This might be the end of the draft, guys. That's not a land. That's not a land. Not a land. Not a land. Not a land, guys. So, Jesus. Yeah, we lose. Cause this any target? Yep. So, we block this. We take 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We block this. We take 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Dang it. That's just disappointing. Turn to slag sucks, man. What was that? How many times did I just like, ugh, I don't like it. Don't like it. I can see why everyone was passing it now. It's too expensive for a removal spell. 5 mana is too expensive. All right, well, that wasn't great. I mean, technically, we got 250. That's more than I thought we were going to get. We'll open our packs, but that's kind of disappointing. So what am I at? I'm 90 gems short. Sometimes they put gems in the store. But I'm probably going to have to wait until the best of one drafts come out. And then draft once and I'll get 90 gems for sure. Let's see. Get a uncommon wild card. That's cool. Sure, Containment Priest. That's pretty cool. Containment Priest is decent. And we get, wow, that's a lot of firsts. Sure. Nyambi. That's a card. This card seems better than people have given it credit for. 2-mana 2-1 with Flash. You can discard one legendary card to draw two cards. Maybe that's okay. I mean, it's card advantage. And then when it enters the battlefield, you can return a target creature you control to its owner's hand. And if you do, you gain life equal to that creature's converted mana cost. I think it's decent. It's decent in response to a removal spell. It's got Flash. 2-mana 2-1 Flash is fine. I think this card is actually better than, like, people have given it credit for. I haven't seen many people talk about it, but it seems, like, okay. Seems okay. So, there we go. We just have to look. The mass. What? The. Oh. Is the store updating? What's going on? Everything's broken. We. Had I actually. Oh, no, it's here. Weird. Weird. Okay. Well, anyway. I didn't get enough for the Mastery Pass, but I definitely will. And that's pretty cool, right? You can technically get enough gems to get the Mastery Pass without actually paying for it. People are always saying, like, is it worth it? Is it worth spending $20 on the Mastery Pass? I mean, it's worth buying it for free, which is what I'm going to do eventually. Actually, before I go, I don't know why I'm doing this on camera. What do I need to do to get 90? You get 52. Or no, 1. I need to go 1 and 3. So I'm not going to do this now, obviously. I'm probably not even going to do it on camera, but as soon as the Best of One quick draft for Core Set 2021 comes out, I will have the Mastery Pass for free. So there you go, guys. That's I don't know why I'm still talking. That's the Core 2021 draft. I always seem to do one draft for each set. That's it. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.